This is Sydney Graham for EFN, in Chairman Forrest News, reporting live from what is sure to be the trial of the century. In a matter of moments, we're about to see the most impressive clash of legal minds this court or this country has seen since once upon a time. After years of delay, we're finally about to witness the trial of the Big Bad Wolf. As many know already, Mr. Wolf, the defendant, escaped the jail sentence after his trial for 3 counts of huffing and puffing with intent to destroy, 2 counts of attempted murder by ingestion, 1 count of grandmother impersonation, 4 counts of attempted sheep abduction, and 17 counts of lurking. And then in a mistrial, the result of a jam falling on the jury room while they were determining the verdict. Now, a number of parties have filed a class action lawsuit against Mr. Wolf in order to seek monetary compensation for what they feel has been an infringement of their human rights. Oh, it seems the counsel for the plaintiffs, the unequaled Miss Fairy Godmother, has arrived with one of her clients, Miss Little Red Riding Hood, and the client's grandmother, Mrs. Grandmother. Hello, Miss Fairy Godmother. Any words for EFN?
Mr. Wolf is a depraved, cold, calculating killer, and it is only his celebrity status in this forest that has saved him from the hands of criminal justice. His behavior is reprehensible and has completely infringed upon my client's rights to live happily ever after. As you know, I have always fought to ensure that the good people of this forest get the ending they deserve.
Now, that wolf is gonna get! We're gonna string him up by his nose and shake him till all of his money falls out right here! And then, me and Remy are gonna get ourselves a nice deal of condo!
That is inappropriate behavior for live television! And we don't want to waste anyone's time! Besides, we can't have this trial going on forever, you know? Mrs. Godmother's clerk won't turn into mice after midnight tonight.
Well, that's lame! You stink!
Oh, well, I never...
No, she will!
Oh! There you have it! Now,
don't you give me no fat? Why am I to blame for every little mishap? All my life time, I think we'll ask him out. Apple me, take me to jail. For the record now, folks, I have nothing to say.
Judge Wise Old Man.
The renowned Judge Wise Old Man is presiding over the case today. Judge Man is known for his, well, wisdom. He's known to frequently apply his gift as a philosopher to any case, and he's also known for his taste for magic beans.
Ladies and gentlemen, they say justice is blind. Well, if justice is blind, if bats are blind, that must mean that justice is bad, eh?
Yeah! No.
You may be seated. In this court today, we are here to try an individual who has been accused of many heinous acts. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want you to keep in mind this important and difficult concept with the many grueling hours of a trial. And that concept is that guilty is the opposite of not guilty, and not guilty is the opposite of guilty. Very well, tell it again. What? He has no counsel? Well, where's his counsel? Did you lose it? Check your pockets, under your seat cushion, behind the refrigerator.
Sir, that's not what I
What? You lost it in the refrigerator?
Sir,
how do you keep your milk fresh? Oh, your lawyer. Well, who was that again? Oh. Miss Evil Stepmother. She's a lot of fun.
I apologize, Your Honor, everyone, for my lateness. Excuse me a moment.
May I inquire to why you were late, Counselor?
You know what? I come up with an excuse, but honestly, I don't do pro bono work. And I'm not all that excited about this case since it's pretty much doomed to failure. I was trying to pull some things together at the last minute, but I pulled up late last night yelling at my daughter to clean the cinders out of the fireplace. So I figured I'd sleep in a little. Treat myself to a nice long breakfast with my colleagues and my witness over there. So, are we gonna get this started? I have a facial at 5.
Yes, of course.
Objection! The trial hasn't even started yet.
Your Honor, I object to the counsel for the defense's attitude. Obviously, she is making a mockery of this court, and you are allowing it.
Am I? Well, that's not good. Miss Stepmother, a bit of wisdom for you. Being late is wrong. Wrong is the opposite of right, and right is the opposite of left. Therefore, if you are late, I may ask you to leave. Now then, court's in session. Oh, open your remarks, Miss Godmother.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we will be correcting a grave injustice. By chance, Mr. Wolf escaped the criminal punishment he so rightfully deserves. He is a depraved criminal. He has lurked these forests for years, preying on innocent little girls.
Yeah! Child!
robbed, and I am sure I am leaving something out. Because of a mere accident, this twisted fiend will not receive the punishment he deserves. So, we must take everything from him that we can. That beast over there must be left with nothing, because he has left my clients hurt, frightened, and homeless. Thank you.
Miss Stepmother!
Oh, no, I waited.
What?
Yeah, you heard me. No statement. Oh, thanks, though.
You're not gonna do anything? Not even gonna try?
Look, Wolfie, nobody's going to save you, and even if they were going to, it sure wouldn't be me.
I'm due. I'm being robbed blind.
Come on, you did all of it, didn't you?
Yeah, but no one understands.
Miss Godmother, call your first witness.
Understand what?
What?
I would like to call Miss Little Red Riding Hood.
What it's like to have everyone hate me. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? What's up, you Hans Christian Andersen?
Yeah, sure.
Maybe I do.
Now, Red dear, how are you?
Well, it'd be a whole lot better if I had that monster cat.
Right, Red. Now. Why don't you tell the nice people on the jury what exactly happened between you and the defendant on the day in question?
Yeah, sure thing. Well, you see, I was walking through the woods, trying to make my way to my granny's house to get her some bread, because, you know, she's old and sick and stuff. When suddenly, this horrible scary wolf jumps out of nowhere and pretends to be all nice and stuff, but like, I know he's creepy, so I'm like, back off, wolf! And he's like, oh no, come on, I'm all nice and stuff. Why don't you take this shortcut or whatever to get to your granny's house? And then I think, well, actually, shortcuts are good. And I hate walking. It's for losers. Oh. And I guess this wolf wouldn't just make up some shortcut or whatever. So I start walking. Turns out the freaking wolf did make it up. He gave me like a long cut or something. So he could get to my granny's house and eat her!
My word, he ate your grandmother! I'm so sorry, child. What happened next?
Well, he dressed up as my granny and got in her bed.
My word, this is appalling! What sort of perverse reason could he have had for doing this?
He wanted to trick me into thinking he was my granny. And then, when I got close enough, he ate me!
Ate you too! Consumption of a live human being is a felony, ladies and gentlemen, and an obvious deprivation of one's basic human rights.
Oh, it was terrible. Until Mr. Woodcutter got us out, it was all so dark and clammy and acidic in there.
It must have been horrible.
Oh, it was. Oh, I can't take it.
Why don't you just go sit back down?
Okay.
Objection. I haven't cross-examined the witness yet.
But she's so sad.
Yes, absolutely too sad to be questioned.
You can't do that. See, I have a right to cross-examine this witness.
But I'm too sad! See?
Oh, boo-hoo.
Yes, according to Clause A of the Legal Code 12345 of Section 22F. Extreme sadness may excuse a witness from further testimony.
You just made that up.
The witness is excused.
What?
You heard me. The witness is excused.
This is ridiculous.
Please sit down, Miss Stepmother. Miss Godmother, any further witnesses?
Yes, I would like to call Miss Grandmother Hood.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
You betcha.
Thank you, Grant.
I prefer Mrs. Hood, please.
Right. Now, Mrs. Hood, tell me something.
Mm-hmm.
Are these things yours?
Why, yes. Those are my things.
And what were you wearing the day that you encountered the defendant?
Well, those exact same items.
Anything else?
Just my Andy's beer. But that's none of your business.
Right. Now, is it not correct that when your granddaughter bad wolf eat you, but he made you remove your desperately needed eyeglasses before he did so?
Yes, it was terrible.
Terrible! Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we've heard that word before. Mrs. Hood's granddaughter used the exact same word to describe the events in question. And frankly, I think they are being kind, as it is in their nature to be. So, not only did the defendant eat a granddaughter and her grandma, but he made the poor old woman remove her much-needed eyeglasses. Without her ability to see, the kind of psychological strain Mrs. Hood must have endured would have been unthinkable. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Wolf is a flagrant vandal and a killer
of sheep, not to mention a freak who likes to dress up in granny clothes and devour little old ladies. You're a sicko, Mr. Wolf, and it ain't gonna happen no more.
Mrs. Hood.
My late husband and myself.
I see.
No further questions, Your Honor.
That was a stunning turn of events. This case may prove even more of a battle for Miss Fairy Godmother than she had planned.
Oh, shut up!
What was that?
Hey, baby. I said I didn't work very hard on this case. Doesn't mean I'm still not the best there is.
Miss Godmother, any further witnesses?
Yes. I would like to call Mr. Bill Woodcutter.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
I do indeed.
Now, Mr. Woodcutter, what is it that you do for a living?
Well, you see, I'm a woodcutter, which means I cut wood for a living.
And you are licensed to carry an axe as part of this job, is that correct?
Yes, I am.
And you are allowed to use this axe in cases of emergency, are you not?
I am allowed.
In fact, is it not part of the woodcutter's code that you must respond to innocent people in need?
It is part of the code, and I uphold that part of the code.
So, in other words, if you encounter an emergency in the forest, you are obligated to act quickly and courageously?
Yes, I am.
And so you did, sir. You're a true hero, sir. Hey. No further questions, Your Honor.
Miss Stepmother.
No, there's an emergency in the woods that you need to respond to.
It's not really what to tell, but I see something wrong.
I see. So, you see it then, do you? Well, Mr. Woodcutter, how about you tell me what prompted you to go into Mrs. Cloak's house on the day in question? Did you hear a scream?
No.
Did you see the defendant enter the house and become suspicious?
Okay, I was snooping around the house.
Oh, Snoopy! Whatever for?
Well, I was looking for a panacea off the windowsill.
And why would you do a thing like that? See, I thought that you were a hero.
Because cutting wood don't pay so good. That's why I did the pageants in the first place. We only get the big money for the first place. That's never happened to me, and I was so hungry.
I see. And while you were off snooping and looking to steal something, you happened to see in the window what exactly?
I saw that there wolf lying in the lady's bed, in her clothes, licking his chops.
Well, all right then. But tell me, Mr. Woodcutter, how did you know, and I mean absolutely know, for sure, that Mr. Wolf had eaten your friend and that you were justified in cutting him open? Because that is what you did, isn't it? You cut my client open with an axe, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
How did you know, Mr. Woodcutter? How did you know that Mr. Wolf wasn't simply one of Mrs. Wood's friends that you didn't know? One who occasionally likes to wear her neck out. But how did you know that he had eaten her and that she wasn't simply in another room?
I mean, look at him. He's a wolf.
Oh. So you just gotta cut him open, right? Because he's a wolf.
Yes.
No other reason?
No other reason.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Another steering cross-examination from Miss Evil Stepmother. This is very interesting.
Oh, shut up!
No witness is excused. Miss Godmother, do you care to call a witness?
Yes. I'd like to call three witnesses.
Objection. You can't call three witnesses at once.
Your Honor, it is essential to my case that the witnesses all be called at once.
Is it?
Your Honor, no, but they insist on testifying together.
Your Honor, may I approach the bench?
Well, this is unorthodox, but I suppose so. Counselors, won't you join us?
Very well. May the three little pigs please approach the stand.
swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
Yes.
Good enough. Now, would you each please give the court your names?
My name is One.
One. Don't you mean?
No, you really, really don't want to get into that.
My name is Tiwo.
My name is Three.
Well, I have a house. Then if so now. And now I live in another house.
And how did your first house blow down?
Well, a fox blew it down.
A fox? Don't you mean a wolf?
Gladly, my dear lady. Well, you see,
My siblings and I used to live with our parents in our childhood home, up until last year when we decided to leave and build our own homes. Not too far away, but far enough to give ourselves a reasonable amount of independence.
I see.
Well, one day, that blasted, bloated, maniacal wolf came around and blew down both my siblings' houses. And they came to live with me out of fear that he might eat them. We lived in such fear for such a time as he lurked outside our homes. We barely ate. We barely slept. And our personal hygiene went to the dogs. Look at all this hair on my chinny chin chin! I haven't shaved in weeks!
Oh, you poor deer, you poor deers!
Yes, it was abominable.
Ladies and gentlemen, these pigs were so scared, they couldn't even shave!
Yes, and he said he would huff and puff and blow our houses down. And he called us little pigs.
Doesn't everyone?
Well, yes. But he said it in a really nasty sort of way that made me think he was trying to demean us. It hurt my feelings immensely.
Well, Your Honor, I am too outraged with the defendant's behavior. I have no more questions.
Your stepmother.
Thank you, Your Honor. Onik, tell me something.
I once tried a pig on my own feet. Want me to tell you?
No. No. I want you to tell me what your first house was made of.
Oh, well, I had a house, and it was made out of straw.
Made out of straw, great. And you, Zwo.
And me? I'm not kosher.
No, I don't want you to tell me something. Tell me what your first house was made of.
That has nothing to do with me not being kosher.
No, it doesn't.
And that's okay?
Yeah, just tell me what your house was made of.
Oh, sticks.
Sticks?
Yeah.
Great. Three, what was the house, in which you three currently reside, the house that you constructed, what was it made of?
It was made out of brick.
Brick. And it hasn't blown over by means of wolf or anything else?
No, it hasn't.
And I assume that it's up to all the building codes.
Of course. What do you take me for? An animal?
Now, three, would you say the same about sticks? Are sticks and straw material approved by a zoning board?
No, they're not.
I didn't think so.
And how long do you think they would have lasted in, say, a hurricane or a tornado? Or, well, a light breeze?
Not that long.
But they're safe and cozy now, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
Now, I just have one more question for you.
Yeah?
Did my client ever say that he was going to eat you?
No!
No.
No.
Then how do you know that's what he wanted to do? How do you know that he wasn't just trying to make sure your homes were safe and secure?
Well, because...
No further questions, Your Honor.
Wait, the three little, I mean, the witnesses are excused. Ms. Governor, do you have any further witnesses?
Yes, I would like to call Mr. Old Shepherd.
The whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me, Hans Christian Andersen.
Yes, I do, Your Honor.
Now, Mr. Shepherd, what is it that you do?
I'm a shepherd. I herd sheep.
And could you tell us who that boy is over there?
That's my boy. He sometimes helps me herd sheep.
And what did he say to you one day?
Let's see. Well, on the third day, today? Let me see. Well, on the first day, the boy cried wolf and said he was out in the field. So all of us in the village come out to take a look. But that wolf was not there. So he did the same thing on the second and the third day, and well,
there was no wolf. So, your boy isn't very reliable then, is he?
I guess he's not.
And no one but the boy actually saw my client steal your sheep or threaten him.
Well, I guess not.
So, then the only way we could know what really happened is by hearing what the boy has to say.
I suppose so.
Your Honor, this man's testimony is essentially hearsay.
Then why are you still talking to him?
Your excuse.
Does the counsel for plaintiffs have any further witnesses?
No.
Miss Stepmother.
Yes, the defense would like to call a surprise hostile witness. The defense calls the boy who cried wolf. Oh, boy, ladies and gentlemen, this is gonna be good.
Objection! Oh, never mind.
Come along, young man.
I don't want us.
I'm afraid you must.
Fine.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So, Hans Christian Andersen?
Yeah, whatever.
Tell me something, young man. Did you, on any day, see a wolf in the field?
Yeah, of course I did. It was on the third day that the old guy said. It was early one night, I was in by a tree, playing my flute in the tent to the flock. Slowing down, could you hardly see, but I saw that wolf right there. I was through the forest, driving, howling, making a fuss. My way I couldn't go. And they ran like a man, and I cried wolf.
He cried wolf.
I cried wolf. Look, can I go? I got to flush some fish down the toilet.
No, I'm good.
stepmother, do you have any further witnesses?
Yes, the defense would like to call to the stand an expert witness in the Raven Falls, Miss Muffet. Jeez, now it's like 5 years of hands-on experience in the deep, dark woods.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth? So help you, Pod, Christine Anderson.
I don't like swearing.
I'm afraid you must, Miss Muffet.
Right, yes.
Thank you.
You're
you may be seated, Miss Muffet.
Oh, no.
Pardon?
I kiss it with my tuppet.
What?
Her tuppet, sir. She needs a tuppet.
Oh, yes. Well, someone go fetch her a tuppet, please.
I don't think anyone else might.
Oh, thank heavens, because neither do I.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. She's a bit neurotic. But I promise you, she's the best there is. If you have a tuppet.
Oh, what's taking so long?
Miss Muffet requires
a tuppet! I can sit with my tuppet!
And like that, I say, there's no such good psychiatry without a sturdy tuppet. For a love, that is all good. What is a tuppet?
I don't know. I think she's made it up. Why doesn't she just stand?
Very well. Miss Muffet, the state is unable to provide you with so sad tuppet. Do you mind standing?
My legs hurt. I need a tuppet.
Please.
Well. Oh, this is ridiculous. Sit.
There's a spider in my chair. There's a spider in my chair. I need some curds away. I need some curds away. I need them so badly.
Like a great glove for one set. Curds in the way. Your day is okay.
Yes, of course, Your Honor. In any event, I apologize for the behavior of my witness. May I simply call my final witness?
I see, why not?
The defense calls to the stand Mr. Big B. Wolf.
Swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help you, Hans Christian Andersen.
Very well.
Mr. Wolf, let's keep this brief. Why don't you just tell the courtroom what you have to say about all this?
Very well. Well, I'm a wolf of few words, so. Well, there it goes. As a cub, I lived a pretty carefree life. Spent most of my days in a cave and played with my brothers and sisters. Mom would bring us meat home for dinner every day, but one day she brought us something different. A human baby. Now, don't worry. We raised her as one of our own, and I loved my sister. She was a wolf herself. But one day she went back to her people and I never saw her ever again. That day, I promised that I'd love and protect creatures of other species, and I swore off the usual duties of wolfhood and became a vegan. But one day, I was in a meadows and looking for dandelions, and all of a sudden, boy cried out, wolf, he's gonna eat me. He's gonna eat my sheep. Suddenly became enraged. How could this boy suspect me of doing something that I'd promised not to do? I yelled at the boy, telling him, I'm a good wolf, but every time, he just screamed. I became enraged and stole his sheep and hanged them that evening and scared him half to death. I tried to put my wits back together after that, but every time I encountered a creature of another species, he or she would distrust me or scream or run off or do something of the sort. Eventually, didn't know how to interact with people. I turned to a life of crime. But, okay, I admit it. I did all the things. But, please, have mercy on me. I'm different now. Please, have mercy on me. Different. Oh, that's all.
That courtroom was thrown into chaos when the renowned psychiatrist Miss Muffet revealed her true identity as the adopted human sister of Mr. Wolf. Miss Fairy Godmother restated what her witnesses had said for her closing remarks. And Miss Evil Stepmother for the defense said that the wolf had not been born a criminal, but made one because of the society in which he lived and believed him as such. Now, we'll take you back to the courtroom where they are about to deliver their final verdict.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want you to give us a verdict.
They haven't even
left. Hush! No one likes jury duty. I know I certainly didn't. All those witnesses crying, the lawyers yakking. Don't even get me started on those judges.
What? You're not gonna send them out to deliberate?
No, we'll have them clap. It's much easier, don't you think? Now, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want to impart some words of wisdom to you. Words of wisdom that may help you along the way. And that wisdom is that jury are like submarine sandwiches. They're the best with mayo and hot peppers. Now then, I want all those who believe that the wolf is guilty and that it's guilty with a J. I mean, guilty with a G. I want all those to applaud now.
Unfortunately.